Alright, Joe, so we're going to illustrate the movie technique, and I want to show you how we break down a distressing memory so that we can reduce the intensity of the emotion, so that when you retell the story, there's less reaction. And the goal being that if this happens again in the future or something similar, that the reaction is different, that you will respond differently because you're not bringing that old experience with you. So you have a memory to work on.
Yeah.
Well, just want to check, because some memories are very distressing and I need to take the edge off so you feel comfortable sharing with me. So if you were to have a quick sort of think about it, how intense do you think the emotion might be out of 10?
Might be about eight.
So if it's an eight, it's quite high. If you think about that eight now, where do you feel that in your body?
My chest.
In your chest. So we're just going to take the edge off that. We want to also give this movie a title. So can you give this movie a short title that represents what happened?
Emma's episode of being quite seriously unwell and having to go to hospital.
Yes. We might make that shorter because we're going to say that a few times.
Emma's episode.
As long as you can tune into it. Okay. And you said it's in your, did you say it's in your chest?
Yeah.
We're just going to take the edge off so you feel more comfortable. So we're actually just going to start tapping the top of the head and just saying Emma's episode. Because I don't want you to go into it in your mind, just stay with me, but your subconscious starts to prepare itself. Emma's episode. We go to the eye. We can do two hands if you like.
Emma's episode.
Side of the eye. Emma's episode.
Emma's episode.
This feeling in my chest.
Emma's episode.
This feeling in my chest.
Recalling Emma's episode.
This feeling in my chest. Emma being unwell. This feeling in my chest. Take a big breath in. Let it go. We've only done one quick round, but I want you to take a quick look at it in your mind again and tell me, is it still an eight? In your chest.
That'd be seven, actually.
Might do a little bit more. Top of the head.
This feeling in my chest.
Eyebrow. Emma's episode.
This feeling in my chest.
Emma being really unwell. This feeling in my chest.
Recalling Emma's episode.
Tapping the chin. This feeling in my chest. Collarbone. Emma's episode. This reaction in my chest. I'm choosing to let it go.
So I can deal with it better.
Let's take a breath in and let it go. Just noticing how the chest is feeling. Just having a little look into that memory, just a little bit, noticing if you feel a little calmer or... Because sometimes people are innate, but they just want to tell me. I want to make sure you're comfortable. Are you happy to tell me what happened?
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So for the purpose of somebody with a big trauma, I would make sure they felt really comfortable to share, of course, and get their permission. I'm not saying this isn't a big trauma, but you're ready. So
yeah.
So what we're going to do is I'm just going to get you to start to tell me what happened. And at each point you get any kind of reaction or discomfort, it's important you tell me. I'm also going to be watching you, because then we're going to address that emotion. But there's something else here as well I'd like to ask you. Is there a peak to this memory that you feel you want to go to first, that's kind of the worst bit?
Yes, probably.
Yes. Shall we just start there?
Yeah.
And even if you're as you're about to speak and you feel anything, we're going to address that. So just in your own time.
Yeah. Well, it's the panic that I've been sitting with her for a while when she's having this episode. And
yes.
Her blood pressure is going through the floor and then the heart rate is really, really high.
Yes.
And it was the panic of not knowing what to do.
So do you feel that now? Do you have a response to that memory now?
Yeah.
Okay, where is that in your body?
In my chest, it's in my throat.
So we're not going to do a setup statement because you tuned in. This panic in my chest and throat.
This panic in my chest and throat.
Eyebrow, this panic in my chest and throat.
This panic in my chest and throat.
Side of the eye. I want you to say it in a short statement, why are you panicking? This panic about
not knowing what's going to happen.
Under the eye. This panic about not knowing what's going to happen.
Not knowing what's going to happen.
Under the nose. Say a little bit more if you want to. This panic.
This panic about so high, I think it's going to cause a heart attack.
Okay. It's panic about her having a heart attack.
It's panic about her having a heart attack.
Is that summing it up?
Panic about her dying.
Okay, that's it, isn't it? Mm-hmm. It's panic about her dying.
Panic about her
dying.
Are
you okay saying these words?
Yeah.
Okay, you can say them in your mind if you don't feel comfortable under the arm. This panic.
This panic.
Tapping the ribs. This panic about her dying.
This panic about her dying.
Top of the head. This panic in my chest and throat.
This panic in my chest and throat.
My eyebrow. This panic about her dying.
This panic about her dying.
This panic about knowing what to do.
This panic about knowing what to do.
Her blood pressure dropping.
Her blood pressure dropping.
Her heart rate increasing.
Her heart rate increasing.
This panic about her dying.
This panic about her dying.
Colour, this panic in my chest.
This panic in my chest.
This fear in my chest and throat.
This fear in my chest and throat.
I'm just going to introduce a word, I hope it's okay. I'm choosing to know she's safe.
I'm choosing to know she's safe.
She didn't die.
She didn't die.
Because I know there's that threat, but just to instruct to your subconscious right now at least, to give a bit of relief, tapping the ribs. All this panic and fear in my chest.
All this panic and fear in my chest.
And my throat.
And my throat.
Let's just take a breath in. Is it still here and here?
It's still there, because it sort of carried on for quite a long time, because the ambulance people came around and they couldn't get her heart rate down.
Yes.
And then she's whisked up to hospital. It kind of just carried on throughout the whole scene of it.
Yes.
All the way to
and
the
you can
hospital.
Okay, so you're feeling that scene of it now?
Yeah.
Yeah. So top of the head, we're just going to talk through that. It went on for ages.
It went on for ages.
Eyebrow. This whole scene.
This whole scene.
It took forever.
It took forever.
It makes me feel scared.
It makes me feel scared.
I feel it in my throat and chest.
I feel it in my throat and chest.
And then it took too long. It
took too long.
I think she was worried about her dying.
I was worried about her dying.
Having a heart attack.
Having a heart attack.
It took too long.
It took too long.
Is it fear that you feel now, or what's the feeling that you have now?
Panic fear.
Okay. This panic.
This panic.
Under the arm. This panic.
This panic.
This panic about Emma.
This panic about Emma.
And just thinking about that memory, this panic about Emma.
This panic about Emma, feeling helpless.
Feeling helpless, okay. I might go side of the hand and do a setup statement, even though I felt helpless.
Even though I felt helpless.
As her mum.
As her mum.
Thought she was going to die.
I thought she was going to die.
And I'm panicking right now.
I'm panicking right now.
Remembering that.
Remembering that.
I love and accept myself.
I love and accept myself.
Even though I feel this panic.
Even though I feel this panic.
Even though I feel helpless as a mum sometimes.
Even though I feel helpless as a mum sometimes.
I'm open to knowing.
I'm open to knowing.
I'm doing the best I can.
I'm doing the best I can.
But right now I'm panicking.
But right now I'm panicking.
Just as if it's happening now.
Just as if it's happening now.
Top of the head. This remaining panic.
This remaining panic.
Eyebrow. All this panic.
All this panic.
Side of the eye. This anxiety.
This anxiety.
Feeling helpless.
Feeling helpless.
Under the eye. Feeling helpless.
Feeling helpless.
Under the nose. Feeling helpless.
Feeling helpless.
All this panic.
All this panic.
Taking a breath in as you tap the collarbone. Big breath in. And let it go. Is it still as strong? What number is the panic right now?
It's gone down.
To what number?
It's gone down to about 6, I think.
Okay.
5 or 6.
Under the arm. This remaining panic.
This remaining panic.
Is it still chest and throat?
I know, it's just still like it's gone chills into my body.
Yes, are you okay to keep going?
Yes.
This is you processing trauma. Tapping the ribs. All this panic.
All this panic.
I'm choosing to let it go.
I'm choosing to let it go.
Top of the head. All this panic.
All this panic.
I'm choosing to let it go.
I'm choosing to let it go.
All this panic. Say exactly where it is and what it feels like.
All this panic that I'm feeling and chills all around my body that's being released.
Side of the eye. All these chills.
All these chills.
Are being released.
Are being released. I'm choosing to let it go.
Good. Do you need a blanket or something? You're okay.
It's okay.
All these chills.
All these chills.
When I recall what happened.
When I recall what happened.
Under the nose. But a part of me knows.
Part of me knows.
She's at home right now.
She's at home right now.
And she's safe.
And she's safe.
And she didn't die.
And she didn't die.
Tapping. And I know there's other issues around that,
but
we're dealing with now, okay. This panic.
This panic.
I feel these chills.
I feel these chills.
As I release this trauma.
As I release this trauma.
For Emma and me.
For Emma and me.
Good, under the arm. This remaining panic.
This remaining panic.
I'm choosing peace and calm instead.
Peace and calm instead.
For Emma and me.
For Emma and me.
Good. This remaining panic.
This remaining panic.
I'm choosing to feel at ease.
I'm choosing to feel at ease.
Because when I feel at ease.
Because when I feel at ease.
I'm more present with Emma.
I'm more present with Emma.
And is there anything else you want to say?
No.
Okay, let's just stop for a sec, take a big breath again. to yourself from letting go of the body's response to all the other, you know how this works now.
Yeah.
So it's really important to do this work for yourself, because of course we don't know the future. But what we do know is that when we clear the trauma of these memories, you are going to be in a very different space should it happen again. And energetically, we could even say that, of course, we know she's very sick, but we also know that things can shift and change energetically with her when you're also different.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's really good you're doing this. So let's just do a little recap. You're still feeling cold?
Yeah, a little bit.
That's your body's response to dealing, as you know, with letting go of the trauma. So, I mean, don't feel cold. You can put your jacket on.
It's fine.
You know yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just going to do a test for the purpose of this demonstration as well. So, can you tell me again what happened, that peak of it, and just notice the response you have of panic or fear, and let me know if there's
any. It was a feeling of being on my own and not knowing what to do. Although I was trying to stay calm for her, I was actually inside feeling blind panic and thinking, you know, her heart rate can't carry on going this fast for so long. Then the ambulance people were trying to get her heart rate down.
Can I stop you? Sorry, that little bit that you just said, feeling of panic and not being able to get heart rate down, are you responding to that now with panic as you say it?
I'm feeling a little bit of it in my body.
Where?
Stomach.
So we need to just address that a bit more again. Top of the head, this fear in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach.
Eyebrow, this fear in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach.
Not being able to do anything.
Not being able to do anything.
All this fear in my stomach.
All this fear in my stomach.
This fear in this stomach because?
This
and
fear
say
my
why.
This fear in my stomach because I don't know where the episode is leading and I have no control.
Tapping the shin. This fear in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach.
Collarbone. This fear in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach. Feeling helpless.
Yeah. This helpless feeling.
This helpless feeling.
Under the arm. This helpless feeling in my stomach.
This helpless feeling in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach.
I didn't know where it was going.
I didn't know where it was going.
I didn't know if she was going to survive.
I didn't know if she was going to survive.
I thought she might die of a heart attack.
I thought she might die of a heart attack.
So it's no wonder I have fear in my stomach.
Yes, I have fear in my stomach.
Yeah, top of the head. But actually, she's safe at home.
She's safe at home.
Eyebrow, but I still have fear.
But I still have fear.
Side of the eye. All this fear in my stomach.
All this fear in my stomach.
The ambulance took too long.
The ambulance took too long.
I felt overwhelmed and helpless.
I felt overwhelmed and helpless.
This helplessness in my stomach.
This helplessness in my stomach.
This fear of not being able to help her.
This fear of not being able to help her. And not trusting that they can help her. That's
right. So this is another aspect. Yeah. This is another piece of it. Yeah. Which is worth dealing actually with separately, because this is your life at the moment. Mm-hmm. So this, I get that, you know, you need to be able to trust people. And if you see something doesn't go the way you want it to, and but let's just deal with what we're dealing with at the moment. This feeling in your stomach, let's take a breath in.
Yeah, it's a bit bad.
Okay, can you say it again though, what you said to give that fear? It was about, say that piece again for me.
Well,
feeling helpless.
Feeling helpless when I called the ambulance, and then they were in her room, these two guys, and they were trying to get her heart rate down. And I could tell they were panicking a bit because nothing was working.
Right, so this is different to what we just dealt with, though. That was your panic about you being helpless. Is that feeling a bit...
But it's part of the whole...
Yes, the whole out-of-control situation. Yeah. So that bit that you just said, can you say that again and tell me where you have that feeling of, well, they don't even know what they're doing. Where's that showing up in your body?
Fear.
Still stomach.
Yeah.
Side of the hand, we'll just do it. Because we need to acknowledge this. So even though I'm afraid. When I remember what happened. I felt helpless.
I felt helpless.
But I was relying on them when they came. But they didn't seem to know what they were doing.
They didn't know what they were doing.
And they were panicking too.
So
it's no wonder I have this panic. That's right. I love and accept myself. Even though I have this panic. About her losing her life. Because no one knows what they're doing. That's the reality, isn't it? Mm. Okay, top of the head. This panic.
In my stomach.
This fear.
This fear.
In my stomach. We're just going to keep doing this. This fear.
In my stomach.
Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
Seeing the professionals panic.
Seeing the professionals not knowing what they're doing.
That's it. Makes me afraid.
Makes me afraid.
All this fear.
All this fear.
Seeing them not knowing what they're doing.
Seeing them not knowing what they're doing.
We're going to slow this statement down. Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
Because I want you to connect to it. Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
They didn't know. They didn't seem to know what they were doing.
They didn't seem to know what they're doing.
This fear in my stomach.
This fear in my stomach.
Under the arm. Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
See them panic in your mind. Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
Seeing them panic.
They're the professionals.
They're the professionals.
I'm feeling so scared.
I'm feeling so scared.
And I don't trust them.
And I don't trust them.
And I have this fear in my stomach.
And I have this fear in my stomach.
But it is time to let it go.
It's time to let it go.
Because she got through it.
She got through it.
And so did I.
And so did I.
Top of the head. So maybe it's time to let this go.
It's time to let this go.
Does it sound okay to say those words?
Yes.
Okay, if there's big resistance, then it's not
time.
It does,
I feel all the chills coming out.
Okay, good. Eyebrow. I'm open to letting this go.
I'm open to letting this go.
These chills are letting it go.
These chills are letting it go.
I'm open to letting this go.
I'm open to letting this go.
Because maybe we all did our best.
Because maybe we all did our best.
Under the nose, maybe there's something to learn here.
Something to learn here.
Tapping the chin. I'm learning here.
I'm learning here.
Anything else you want to say?
It's a very rare condition and they hadn't heard of it before. They were Googling it at the scene.
Yeah, wow. Okay. Yeah. So when you say that, they'll Google it, does that make you feel panic or are you having a bit of relief around that? What's happening?
Maybe feel helpless. They had the best intention.
Okay.
But they didn't know what they're doing.
They did, and that's the fact.
Yeah.
Yeah. But is the charge in that or is there more of a that's what happened and that's how it is?
No, it's I'm feeling it is what it is.
Okay.
Because I don't know what they were doing.
Okay, good. All right. Under the arm. Let's stop actually and do a little check in. Good. Big breath in. Just did that and let it go.
Yeah, I mean it's shit really, but
yeah.
How it is,
yes,
it's just fact that, you know, and when she actually got into the hospital the staff were Googling it as well.
Yeah.
And I'm telling them how to spell the condition.
Yes. Wow.
So, yes, you know, it's not, I'm not feeling frightened talking about that bit now.
Okay.
It's just kind of like, it's just kind of unbelievable that.
Yes. So is there, so that's good. You're not feeling frightened. So there's not that fear reaction.
No, I'm not saying that now.
Is your stomach feeling better?
Yeah.
Is there any fear in your stomach? Just say the whole thing again for me. We're just testing here again. So can you just start again?
Well, from the beginning, she started having this really bad episode.
Yes.
I was in a, you know, bit of a blind panic. I had to know when to call the ambulance or, you know, then it just carried on and got worse.
Is the blind panic now?
No, I'm not feeling it.
Good.
That's good. Yeah.
Yeah, good. Keep going.
Yeah, so, yeah, it's the waiting for them to come and then witnessing them, you know, not knowing what they're doing.
Yeah. It's the fear now when you say that.
A little bit of apprehension. It's not like,
Yeah, but that, we're going to do just two rounds on the apprehension because that's not a nice feeling either when you feel like what's going to happen.
Yeah.
So let's go top of the head. This apprehension.
This apprehension.
Not knowing what's going to happen.
Not knowing what's going to happen.
This apprehension.
This apprehension.
Say it in your words, yeah.
This apprehension of not knowing what's going to happen when she has her next episode.
Yeah, so that's also now going into the future a little bit. So just tune into that feeling. This apprehension.
This apprehension.
Under the eye. Not knowing what's going
to
happen.
Knowing that it's going to happen again.
Under the eye.
Not knowing which competent or incompetent doctor you're going to get to deal with it.
So feel that feeling under the nose, this apprehension.
This apprehension.
This apprehension.
This apprehension.
This apprehension.
This apprehension.
Not knowing who or what's going to happen.
Not knowing who or who's going to help.
And how they're going to do it.
And how they're going to do it.
This apprehension.
This apprehension.
I'm acknowledging it now.
I'm acknowledging it now.
Where is the apprehension in your body?
It's in my throat.
Okay. This apprehension in my throat.
This apprehension in my throat.
Take a big breath in. Top of the head, this apprehension in my throat.
This apprehension in my throat.
Say what you need to say, Jo, because it's in your throat and needs saying.
This apprehension, worrying about when it's going to happen again.
Yeah, eyebrow. It's important that you verbalise.
Worrying about who is going to help me. Worrying which situation I'm going to be in and where I'm going to be.
Yeah.
And depending which doctor gets. And if, you know, trusting them.
Yeah.
Knowing if I can trust the doctor.
So feel that in the throat, all this apprehension in my throat.
All this apprehension in my throat, trusting professionals.
That's it.
Just sometimes don't know what they're doing.
That's it, under the arm. Let's keep it short and sweet now. All this apprehension.
All this apprehension.
Good, tapping the ribs. All this apprehension.
All this apprehension.
Not knowing if I can trust people.
Not knowing if I can trust people to know what to do.
That's it. All this apprehension.
All this apprehension.
Not knowing if I can trust people.
Not knowing if I can trust people.
With knowing what to do to help.
What to do to help.
All this apprehension in my throat.
All this apprehension in my throat.
All this fear in my throat.
All this fear in my throat.
All this fear of the future in my throat.
All this fear of the future in my throat.
I'm choosing to acknowledge it.
I'm choosing to acknowledge it.
I can feel it right now.
I can feel it right now.
I'm choosing to let it go.
I'm choosing to let it go.
Yeah, amazing. Are you processing this?
Yes.
Yeah. All this apprehension in my throat.
All this apprehension in my throat.
This release in my throat.
This release in my throat.
Top of the head. And if you get really emotional, you know, just go with it.
Yes.
If you can, if you're all right to do that, can you just turn that